Nice little intro though. But this is the start of the game. Little Mouse's Encyclopedia on Nintendo Switch. Just got released now, 23rd of April. And it is rather good. It's short and sweet. You can complete the whole thing in less than an hour. But it does teach you a lot. It's a good learning game for kids, mainly aimed at that market. Lovely hand-drawn artwork. It's really well done. The music's whimsical. Very informative. A lot of information about, you know, species that I know a lot about because I basically grew up with half of these European animals and insects, and they were just found all over the place. You know, they're very, very common, and there's some factoids in there that would be interesting. It's really in depth in a fun sort of way, not in a boring sort of way, and it's really well done. I know you're thinking this is going to be a quick review, but it's almost a 40 minute video, but it's the entire game that I've recorded just so you can just see what this game has and, you know, explore the whole habitat. I enjoyed it. It wasn't a waste of time. I learned a lot about these amazing little creatures. Some I don't like, mosquitoes, you know, leeches. Yeah, it's got all sorts, and it's a very, very decent game indeed. It's just well put together. I was quite impressed with it. Not overly expensive either. It's really affordable. So, you know, if you just want to waste a few hours for the kids, you know, it's worth spending, what, $8.44 at the moment in the dollars. So, yeah, it's really decent. It's less than a tenner. It's cheap. And it's a lot of fun. The artwork itself is really suitable to the way the game is made and presented. And there are about, oh, let's see, 160 species of animals. And plants, of course. The four habitats which I mentioned before, the pond, the forest, the burrows, all there, all really interesting. You know, it's a wonderful little world. You know, it's just exploring nature the old-fashioned way, you know, relaxing music, you know, the simple, you know, control with a Pro controller, or you just use your fingers, because it, you know, you can use a touchscreen. The world, I wish I was a lot larger, because there's so much more out there that we can learn. So I'm hoping it's going to be DLC. Yeah, more DLC. That's what we need to finish off for this quick review. And it's supposed to be a quick review. I'd say if you want to learn a bit more about the burrows, the garden, the, you know, the pond and the forest, yeah, and discover all the 160 objects that you have to discover and find info about, and, you know, obviously a little bit of calming music and calm your kids down. And if you've got children like me who just love exploring the fields and lifting up rocks and discovering little insects and then, you know, gruesomely hold them in front of you to say, "Ooh, look at this, isn't it cool?" And you're just saying, you know, put that down, wash your hands, that's a bit gross, you know. One of my sons is definitely like that, loves picking up insects, and yeah, this is the more hygienic way of discovering insects and animals without actually picking them up and getting dirty. It's a good learning tool, one I'll be using with my children. You know, I've got six kids, so this is a great game to have. You will learn a lot, but I hope there's more content coming soon, because it's too much of a good game just to be this short, really. You know, less than an hour to discover everything, but a lot of information there, a lot of knowledge, and you'll know more about what's around you in your local area, which is really good. So there you go. Definitely worth buying, cheaper than a tenner. Go out and get it while it's on offer. And that's released right now, Nintendo eShop, 23rd of April. So go out and get it. It's a lovely little game. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.